Hey there, in this video we'll be going over how you can use AI to level up your technical writing interview game so you can interview successfully companies like Google, companies like Meta, and much more. And that way, if you want to get a higher salary, if you just want a great technical writing career, well, we can help you do just that with this video here. So make sure to stick with us to the end too, because we're going to cover a number of different tricks and tips. And some of my favorite ones are the ones that we'll be discussing last here. So let's go ahead and dive in to see how AI can help you with your interview process. So here we are in ChatGPT, and we're taking a look at how this tool, which is an AI tool that provides results based on inputted prompts, can help you with your technical writing interview process. And this tool right now has a base free mode, so you can go in and use it for free. And just make sure to check out this URL right here and sign up. They also have a plus mode, because sometimes too many people are using the tool and it won't be working for a short period. And if you have the plus version, which I believe is $20 a month right now, you can go ahead and use the tool whenever you want without it going down. Now let's go ahead and jump in and see exactly what we need to do to be successful at using AI to help us with our technical interviewing process. So the first thing that we want to do is we're going to go ahead and we're going to put in a prompt here. So the first prompt that we put in is provide a list of interview questions for a technical writer position at Google. Now this is specific prompt to some degree, as we're putting a company name in there. So the output should prepare us for a technical writer position at Google rather than a position somewhere else, though there is a lot of overlap in technical writing questions that are asked from company to company. Now let's go ahead and see what output this gives us. And as you can see, the output comes out right away. And that makes this process a lot easier if you're looking for a quick study or you have an interview coming up and you're like, okay, I need to get some example questions and some example answers in my head right away. So here we have a list of 10 different questions that we can choose among that can help us better prepare for a technical writer position at Google. Now, what we want to do too is we can also expand upon this. We can do it a number of ways. Well, first we can do it by getting an answer. Now, when you read something like this, you're like, this is all great, but I don't know the answers to some of these questions, and you may be thinking that. Or maybe you may know all the answers and you're already a great technical writer and where you need to be, but let's say you don't. Well, let's go ahead and plug in a prompt that's going to give us an answer to one of these questions. And we can also ask for answers to all of these questions. So here we put in provide an ideal answer to number 10 using detailed examples. Why? Because interviewers want to have detailed examples when you do reply. So it's important to be able to include those as well. And by saying an ideal answer, you're saying, hey, I don't want just some general answer. I want the best answer possible for this question. Now let's go ahead and plug that prompt in. And one of the things that I love about this is that it's writing the answer from a first person point of view, because you'll be replying in a first person way, right? You're not going to say this person did this. You're going to say I did this. Now you can also make this more specific, and this answer is great. It still operates at a pretty high level though, and you want to be able to personalize it more to your background. So you can say something like provide an ideal answer to number 10 using detailed examples from the fintech industry, or dialing in other ways that are more relevant to your background when you're applying for that said position, whether that be at Google or another company. And one of the things that I really like about this answer that it provides here, and if you have a second, make sure to take a minute just to pause this video to go ahead and read it. You'll notice that it goes and replies to the prompt in a way that covers the many different facets of technical writing and its importance. So it's like, if I'm writing a user guide for a non-technical audience, I assume that they may not be familiar with the jargon and technical terms used in the industry. To tailor my writing to each audience, I make sure to use appropriate terminology and avoid overly technical explanations for non-technical audiences. For example, I may use analogies or metaphors to explain complex concepts in more accessible terms. And conversely, for a more technical audience, I would provide more in-depth explanations and use specialized terminology to ensure clarity and accuracy. So as you can see, The tool is very good at giving answers to these interview questions that cover a number of areas where, as an interviewer, I'd want the person who I'm interviewing, so the candidate, to touch upon. And that's what makes AI so helpful, and particularly ChatGPT in this case. Now, let's go ahead and really dive into a more specific example, because we're not always just interviewing for a technical writer position at a company. You may be interviewing for a very specific position at that company within technical writing. So here I put in a prompt: provide a list of challenging and complex interview questions for an API technical writer position at Google. And this way it's a more specific subset within the technical writer position and can provide you more accurate interview questions if you're interviewing for, again, a subset within that position, which often we do. Now, I put in the terms challenging and complex because I think it's best to be as best prepared as you can for an interview. And in order to make that happen, you should make sure that you can answer the most complex and challenging questions. And if you can do that, well, then you'll have a much better chance at landing the job. And if you just stick yourself to the easier questions, you're going to have a harder time getting the job when they throw a complex or challenging question at you and you can't answer it. So here we have a list of 10 different questions that you can use to prepare for this API technical writer position at Google. One of the things that we can also do, so this is really cool, is we're going to give you an awesome tip here, because you may not be interviewing at Google. You may be interviewing at one of the many other companies that exists. And let's say they have a website. You can actually put in their website domain into this prompt, and it'll analyze their website and give you interview questions according to their industry, their benefits and features that they offer, and much more. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that for my software company. I own a company called Squibbler.io, which helps people with writing books, writing screenplays, and documentation. And we're gonna get interview questions specific to our company for a technical writer position. So provide a list of interview questions for a technical writer position at Squibbler.io that focuses on the company's features and benefits. So ChatGPT is going to analyze this website and gear these questions accordingly. And as you can see, a lot of these questions focus on the features and benefits that the company offers. And I love that it's able to do that. The tool here does a good job at gearing the questions more towards Squibbler and what the company offers, and that enables us to better prepare for an interview at that company. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that these questions are not going to come out the same every time when you plug in this prompt. So I recommend maybe creating a new chat and plugging in the prompt again, and it's going to give you a list of 10 different questions, or maybe 15. And that way you can really prepare for your interview process at whatever company that you're applying for. So sometimes 10 questions is not enough. Sometimes just having a good list of maybe 30 to 40 questions that you can circle around is going to be super helpful for you to cover all your bases when interviewing at a company, especially a top company like Google and other companies within that arena that require an extensive amount of interview skills to land a job at. And there we have it. We just covered how to use AI to help you with the technical writing interview process at different companies, whether that be Google or another company that you want to apply for, and how you can use it to not only give you example questions, but give you example answers that are detailed and personalized to your background. And that way you could come in ready to interview at these top companies and land the job. And if you found this video helpful, make sure to go ahead and subscribe to our channel, like this video, and that way you can keep up to date with all things AI and technical writing and all things technical writing. And with that, I'll go ahead and see you in some of our other videos, and we'll rock and roll from here. Cheers.